Last year, I was contacted by a team out of Georgia who said that they were assisting a family that had a very strange experience going on in their home. They told me nothing crazy was happening yet, but that the family was being visited by a phantom in the window. Of course, being curious, I wanted to try and help. So the team put me in contact with the family, and I spoke to them a few times through Facebook chat. Later that same evening, I received a message on Facebook from the father of the house, and they were very avid fans of Ghost Adventures, Ghost Hunters, and most of the paranormal TV shows you see. So they had a working knowledge of how hauntings worked, but I was also worried that they might have seen something on TV and maybe they were applying it to stuff that was happening in their real lives. They told me that the encounter started a few months before they contacted the team that they were dealing with. They said the house was fine, and then all of a sudden, they started seeing this figure in their son's window. Now, it would be they would be walking by the door and they would just catch a quick glimpse. Or they would be tucking the kid into bed, turning around to say goodnight, and they would see the figure and then it would be gone instantly. But they said over a while, it started escalating. You know, they would see it from once or twice a week to once or twice every 3 days. And by the time they contacted me about a few months after the whole thing started, they were seeing it usually once a day. And they were curious as to what might be causing this. So, because they had an interest in the paranormal and all of that stuff, I asked if they had tried to set up any cameras or maybe set up an audio recorder to see if it could record something. I didn't tell them to communicate with it because it is in their son's room and they were a little creeped out by it, but they told me that they hadn't made any attempts to capture it on film or to maybe record EVPs that could be associated with that spirit. So I asked the paranormal team I was assisting what they thought of the case, and they said that in the research they could do on the house, they couldn't really find much. They said that when they had done a walkthrough, they really didn't feel anything except for there would be times where you definitely felt like eyes were on you, but it was mainly focused outside. You didn't really feel anything inside the house. You would feel things outside the house. So because the family still lived there and their son was less than 3 years old, they really didn't want to try and do a full investigation and invite something into their home. So the team ended up, at my suggestion, doing an investigation outside. Now, this wasn't a full-on investigation. They did two spirit box sessions and then an EVP session. And they really did not get anything. So at this point, I had been assisting the family and the team for about a week or so, and I was still a little confused as to what was going on. Now, unfortunately, I couldn't completely dedicate myself to research on the house, the history of it, because I was actually working on two separate projects at the same time. But the father told me that they had heard when they moved into the house that the guy who sold it to them told them that there was a man who passed away in the living room of the home, apparently of a heart attack or something like that. I can't remember off the top of my head exactly. But they said that they were able to talk to someone who actually knew the person who passed away in the house. And they said that usually he would go out at night to the shed and he would do some late night work. I think it was woodworking or something like that. And they said whenever it was cold, he would bundle up in this little jacket, you know, that looked kind of heavy, and that he would wear a hat for whatever reason. And the father told the person, hey, this is what we've been seeing in the house. And they said that the size of the figure matched about the height of that old man who passed away. So what I was confused about was if this was this person's house and he passed away inside, why was he not able to be in the house, but he was able to be outside and at the window? So I sat on it for a while, thought about it. And then it came to me actually as I was driving down the road one night. Maybe he's just looking in to check up on the house. You know, I don't know how long this guy had lived there. You know, maybe he grew up there. It had strong sentimental value to him. but I got the sense that he might be just checking up on things. He doesn't want to communicate. He doesn't want to disturb them. He's just making sure the house is okay and that everyone there is okay. So what's weird is I went to go communicate this to the team first to see if, you know, they might be feeling the same thing. But before I did, the father of the family in the house contacted me and said, hey, we were thinking about it. Could it be that the person who passed away could be looking over the house? So it was really cool that, you know, I came up with this idea and then the family came up with this idea. And then later the team agreed with me that that was kind of what they were getting from it. And so after a while, we all discussed it. I gave them a few different things they could do, you know, try to say, we respect you, you know, checking up on the place, you know, please don't bother us. We wish to be left alone, that kind of stuff. And I say, you know, if you ever feel anything bad or, you know, the activity progresses, you know, contact the team or contact me and we'll try to help you out. And they were very thankful. They're a very nice family, very good team to work with. And ever since then, I have not heard back from them. So I'm going to assume they're just living with their phantom in the window.